charismatic.tv. Welcome to New Consumer TV. We're here at PeopleTree, the fair trade and environmental fashion company. We're going to be talking to the people that are PeopleTree about what it's like to work here.
Sweet berries ready for two ghosts are no different than you. Ghosts are now waiting for you, are you?
Hello there, can we ask you what you're doing here at PeopleTree?
I'm the wholesale manager here, so I do all the kind of business development. I do the retail, so we have a concession in Topshop and I run that and staff it and manage it. We do bespoke orders for multiples like Timberland and Topshop. We've increased customers from about 11 to about 75 in 2 years.
Can we just ask you what you're doing?
We're basically just looking at the sizing and placement of a graphic for our t-shirts. So we have to make sure it looks right on the smallest size and also on the biggest size.
So we're here with Safia, who's actually the founder of PeopleTree. So to start off, tell us a bit about why you started PeopleTree.
You know, I was buying organic food, I was buying fair trade coffee and tea and bananas and stuff, and I just couldn't find anything in fashion that I wanted to buy that you know ticked all the boxes for me in terms of meeting, you know, good social practice overseas, in terms of protecting the environment. So I ended up starting PeopleTree in Japan, actually. We brought the brand to London 5-6 years ago now.
So I'm here with Sarah. She's just made me a cup of Fairtrade coffee, predictably. How have you found it different to the conventional fashion industry?
It's producer-focused, product-focused, mm-hmm. rather than focused on the consumer and the company itself. It's very much us developing the producers and growing their skills and making sure they understand what it takes to work, to make products for the Western world.
Mm-hmm. Safia visits producers regularly and as do the designers, so we get direct feedback and see kind of up-to-date pictures of the benefits that are being brought to the communities that we work in.
We would work with the producers, we visit the producers, we look at what kind of traditional skills they have, what kind of materials they can source. We may help them to source, for example, organic cotton yarn so they can use that on their hand looms. We may help them with running natural dye workshops to really give better skills and better quality of natural dyes, for example. So when we know what the producer group can produce, then we'll build that into a design spec and design a product that will use those traditional skills.
Because it's hand knitted, so there's always discrepancy in the measurements, so it's quite difficult to control the measurements here because it's all hand knitted in an individual home, you know, the woman hand knit. So it's a bit wonky.
Oh, well, it's still beautiful.
Because PeopleTree has developed the fair trade supply chain, has invested a huge amount of money in actually building the producer capacity at the same time as building a market for fair trade fashion. So PeopleTree took 8 years to become profitable in Japan, and it will be this year before we actually move close to making a profit in Britain. So it takes a lot of time to become profitable.
So you think it is possible to be a profitable business and also be fair trade?
Yeah, just possible, just have to make sure that when it becomes profitable it doesn't become too capitalistic, because the aim is to keep a certain ideal. But I mean, of course it has to be profitable, otherwise there is no point, there is no money to give back to the producers.
Obviously there's issues with volumes of clothes that are produced and can be produced with a fair trade and ethical clothing, but I think it's a business model that should be adopted by mainstream clothing industry.
So why did you come to work at PeopleTree?
I had a strong interest in fair trade fashion in particular. I just wanted to learn more about the difficulties that are involved. You know, why is it so hard to make fair trade fashion work?
We work with very, very long lead times, so we can't be as responsive as perhaps some of the high street is. So when they can respond to trends within 8 weeks, you know, we our lead times are a year long. So we have to plan very far in advance.
PeopleTree have a very long company mission statement in which they aim to be not just fair trade partners and environmentally conscious, but also take care of their own here at home by providing what they call a supportive and nurturing environment. Now, supportive and nurturing are not really words commonly associated with the fashion industry, but it looks like here, fashion can really have a conscience and be profitable too. And why did you come to PeopleTree?
I've been working in the fashion industry for all my career and just came to realise that it was perhaps another way of doing things, and I was really interested in the fair trade model and making that work for fashion.
Whether you are the logistics manager or the person answering the phone or the designer, you all have a common goal and a common interest, which brings us together much more as a team than you would be in an ordinary fashion company where you're quite different kinds of people. So that makes it a very positive place to work.
These are, you know, really excitingly experienced people but want to make a difference in the sphere of fair trade fashion. So we're really, really lucky. I think people come to us because they can express themselves.